I had microneedling. Looks like I have broken capillaries. Will they go away?
Thank you for your question. You submitted your question without a photo, and you're stating in your question that you underwent microneedling and now you're noticing broken capillaries, and you're asking, will they go away? Well, I can give you some idea of what I'm thinking when I'm hearing a question like this in the absence of a photo, and of course, as well as the absence of a time frame. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. Microneedling amongst a wide range of procedures is something we do a lot in our practice. And I would start by asking you whether or not you were aware of the presence of broken capillaries before the microneedling. A lot of times people look at themselves with much more detail after they undergo a procedure. In my practice, I routinely take a lot of photos and I review those photos with my patient. And an example of an indication for microneedling can be to help patients who have sun-damaged skin. Sun-damaged skin is basically characterized by discolorations, wrinkling, and broken capillaries. And so it can be the case that you already had broken capillaries and you may be aware of them after undergoing the microneedling process. I can tell you that a lot of times people look at themselves and see detail of things that they hadn't noticed before. Now let's say the broken capillaries occurred after you underwent the microneedling. Well, the response to wound healing, which is essentially the principle of a lot of different treatments, everything from chemical peels and lasers, all depend on a certain wound healing process. During that wound healing process, there is the proliferation of blood vessels, and therefore it can be possible that the blood vessels are a response of your body to the microneedling treatment. This is something that hopefully you'll be able to make a distinction with the practitioner who performed the treatment. Well, I would say that if you look at wound healing as a process, generally speaking, the phase in which blood vessels can be produced would be in what's called the proliferative phase, and that is the first month after any type of injury. In addition, it might be well worth thinking that about whether or not these vessels have become just much more present and not necessarily caused by microneedling, but just as essentially the natural aging of the skin. Now, it doesn't mean that you age significantly since the microneedling, but it is a common awareness of a common knowledge in the medical field that a lot of these vessels become more obvious as the collagen diminishes in the skin. Now, to treat broken vessels and to treat what's called telangiectasias, we typically use lasers. And we can close off those vessels with the lasers and we can watch and see how significant of an issue they are. And usually that takes a couple of treatments. And it's something I think that you can also explore with your practitioner as far as the management of the vessels. It's always safe to observe. You don't always have to jump on something quickly. But I think that understanding the indications for the microneedling and whether or not it is possible that the level of aggressiveness of the microneedling may need to be potentially adjusted. Again, in the absence of a photo and the details, it's important for you to at least know that microneedling can be as superficial as half a millimeter to all the way down to close to 2 millimeters. And that levels of depth can also be marked also by the aggressiveness and the rate in which the microneedling is performed. There's a lot of nuance in this treatment, and a lot of times well-meaning practitioners will be very aggressive. And from that aggressiveness may result some untoward side effects. But generally speaking, it's a very safe procedure, and I think most practitioners tend to lean on the conservative side to observe. You know, when we do these treatments, we want to see how do our patients respond. You know, a lot of cosmetic dermatologic procedures is done conservatively, basically to treat and observe the response. You can compare it to like the way laser hair removal is done. You tend to do a lower setting or a more conservative setting before you go up on the energy. So I think it's important for you to have a good dialogue with your practitioner and look at the overall strategy, look at the response that you've had to the microneedling. You know, the principle of microneedling is essentially something called collagen induction therapy. And in many ways, it does a lot of things that overlaps with lasers without the heat. So it has a lot of value, but like any tool, it has to be applied in the correct way, in the most optimal way, I should say. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.